Let's see about chlamydial conjunctivitis. Chlamydial conjunctivitis, the causative organism is Chlamydia trachomatis, which has 12 xerovars, which are A, B, BA, C, D, E, F, G, H, J, and K. So this causes two types of diseases. One is trachoma, caused by serotype A, B, B, A, and C. And the next is paratrachoma, also called as adult inclusion conjunctivitis, caused by the serovars D to K. D, E, F, G, H, J, and K. There is no I serotype. First, let's see about trachoma. It is a chronic keratoconjunctivitis. It affects the conjunctiva and cornea simultaneously. Trachoma is one of the leading causes of preventable blindness in the world. This is also known as Egyptian ophthalmia. Causative organism, as you have seen earlier, is Chlamydia trachomatis, serovars A, B, BA, and C. The predisposing factors for trachoma are age. Usually it is seen during infancy, more common in females, in dry, dusty weather. And other predisposing factors include exposure to dust, smoke, and irritants. The mode of transmission could be direct spread, that is airborne or waterborne, vector spread through flies, and material transfer. Coming to the corneal signs, presence of regressive pannus, in which vessels extend a short distance beyond the area of filtration. Presence of Herbert spitz. Corneal opacity is an end result of the corneal trachomatis lesions. Other corneal sequelae include corneal ectasia, corneal xerosis, and total corneal pannus, which is a blinding sequelae. And this is a picture of a regressive pannus. Vessels extend beyond the area of infiltration, and these are the Herbert spitz on the limbal area. Next, let's see the grading of trachoma. First, Mechelin's classification, or the other classification is WHO classification. In Mechelin's classification, trachoma is graded into four stages: stage 1, 2, 3, and 4. First is incipient trachoma or stage of infiltration. Stage 2 is established trachoma or stage of florid infiltration. Stage 3 is cicatrizing trachoma or stage of scarring. Stage 4 is healed trachoma or stage of sequelae. This is Mechelin's classification. Next, WHO classification, we have TF, FISTO classification, F, I, S, T, and O. F is TF, trachomatis inflammation follicular stage. TI is trachomatis inflammation intense stage. TS stands for trachomatis scarring stage. T for trachomatis tichiasis. And CO stands for corneal opacity. These are the five stages of WHO classification: trachomatis inflammation follicular TF, trachomatis inflammation follicular and intense TI, trachomatis scarring TS, trachomatis trichiasis TT, and corneal opacity CO. In trachomatis inflammation follicular stage, the presence of 5 or more follicles in the upper tarsal conjunctiva is characteristic. Follicles are round swellings that are paler than the surrounding conjunctiva, appearing white, grey, or yellow. Follicles must be at least 0.5 mm in diameter. Next stage is trachomatis inflammation intense, TI. It is pronounced inflammatory thickening of the tarsal conjunctiva that obscures more than half of the normal deep tarsal vessels. The tarsal conjunctiva appears red, rough, thickened. They are usually numerous follicles which may be partially or totally covered by thickened conjunctiva. Next is trachomatous scarring, TS. The presence of scarring in the tarsal conjunctiva. Scars are easily visible as white lines, bands or sheets in the tarsal conjunctiva. They are glistening and fibrosis in appearance. Scarring, especially diffuse fibrosis, may obscure the tarsal blood vessels. The fourth stage is trachomatous trichiasis, TT. At least one eyelash rubs on the eyeball. Evidence of recent removal of internal eyelashes should also be graded as trichiasis. Corneal opacity, CO. Easily visible corneal opacities can occur over the pupil. Pupillary margin is blurred viewed through the opacity. Such corneal opacities cause significant visual impairment, less than 6 by 18 or 0.3 vision, and therefore visual acuity should be measured if possible. Treatment. Topical regimes include tetracycline 1% or erythromycin 1% ointment for 6 weeks, sulfacetamide 20% eye drops thrice a day along with 1% tetracycline for 6 weeks, and the systemic regimens include tetracycline or erythromycin 250 mg orally 4 times a day for 3 to 4 weeks, doxycycline 100 mg orally twice a day for 3 weeks. Treatment of complications include for trichiasis, we perform epilation, electrolysis or cryolysis. For entropion, we perform surgical correction. Follicles are mechanically expressed by rollers, forceps, silver nitrate painting or diathermy. Concretions are removed with the help of hypodermic needle. Pannus with the help of cryoapplication or peritomy, or xerosis, which is treated by artificial tears. We have seen about trachoma till now. Now let's go to adult inclusion conjunctivitis. Acute follicular conjunctivitis associated with mucopurulent discharge is the adult inclusion conjunctivitis, usually affects sexually active young adults. Causative agents is serotype D2K of Chlamydia trachomatis. Source, urethritis in males, cervicitis in females. Mode of transmission, direct transmission from the genitals or contaminated water or swimming pools. The symptoms include ocular discomfort, mild photophobia, mucopurulent discharge. The signs are conjunctival hyperemia, which is noted in the lower palpebral conjunctiva, acute follicular hypertrophy, superficial keratitis and preauricular lymphadenopathy. Treatment for this is topical therapy by tetracycline 1% ointment 4 times a day for 6 weeks. Systemic therapy is azithromycin 1 gram single dose repeated after 1 week, which is the drug of choice. So azithromycin 1 gram single dose, which is repeated after first week, is the drug of choice. Tetracycline or erythromycin 350 mg 4 times a day for 3 to 4 days can also be given, and the sexual partner should also be treated simultaneously. This is all about chlamydial conjunctivitis. Thank you.